Good day. My name is James McKillop. I've been living in Glasgow, Scotland since 1971. I led an ordinary life until the late 90s. And to cut a long story short, I was diagnosed with dementia in November 1999. That's a long time in the dementia world.
Self-management came around about 2007 and 2008, and because of the lockdown I've been going through old CDs and paperwork, and I found out I was doing something around about 2006. It was self-management under a different name. It was called Citizen Leadership. I remember the first time I heard it, I was at a meeting. And I thought, my God, do they mean we have to manage our lives? So I just didn't understand the term at that time. Now, of course, it means that you are in charge of your life and you direct people as to what they do, and which, of course, is the way it should be. I know in the past I had things, but they were offered to me in a sort of a take it or leave it. You know, you couldn't sort of do a choice. It was either their way or nothing. That was shocking. But then I joined a group with Brenda. Well, Brenda was the boss, and I could choose what I wanted to do. When I bought out a book of photographs, Brenda would take me out where I wanted to go and any time of the day or any conditions. For example, in my book, I've got a photograph of the horse in the M8 as you come from Edinburgh to Glasgow, and I've got it in the snow. But I'd say to her, I'd like to take a picture of horse in the snow. And one day I was sitting at home and the phone rang and it was Brenda saying, there's a lot of snow, get ready. And off we went. So there was another support worker there. They stood chattering with the cold while I took my photographs. I didn't feel the cold then. When you take photographs, everything else, every discomfort goes out of your mind. So again, that was really at the forefront in those days. I don't have any self-directed support or that, because I've heard how hard it is to get it. There's so many hoops to jump through. So I don't want any hassle at that. So, and again, I've got a great wife. So all my needs have been met just now. But it's because of recent illnesses and like a TIA, I'm needing help with transport now. I can't walk very far and I've got balance problems. So, apart from my wife, there's not really anybody that I can direct it to help me. Mm-hmm. I don't have anybody. I know I've got one video. I used to do an hour's presentation of my life, and it showed how started off well, disintegrated into dementia. Meeting Brenda brought me back to life, and I was able to contribute to society again. And there is one video available. Uh-huh. I've still got it. Back in 2001 or 2002, I applied to the Millennium Commission for a grant. One, to bring out a help card for people with dementia. That is still being used these days at the back of a NHS booklet. And it also applied for, in the same application, for money to bring out a calendar for people with dementia. So I didn't know anything about ethics or anything, but Brenda took me around care homes and places where people with dementia were. And I asked people their opinions. I made up 8 pro formas of the calendar. So I went round, showed them and asked them what they preferred. So out of the eight, it narrowed down to three a tape, and it seemed to be more for the early stages, middle stages and later stages. But I didn't have funds for three, so I went for a middle one and produced 1,000 calendars. And I had my own photographs for it. And I had other wee things in it to try and jog people's memories. And so that was a 2003 calendar. So I said, I did the research with Brenda's help, because she drove me, but I wasn't driving. So as I said, but ethics, hadn't heard of it. Hadn't heard of anything. I just did it off my own bat. The book ran out. It's never been republished. And I saw one, and I think it was eBay recently, for £20. It cost £10 new. I've got a DVD of Citizen Leadership. Someday my son isn't able to come and visit, but one day I'll be able to get these copied. I've even marked on them, is this the start of self-directed support?
But there's things I can't do. I don't think about them. I think about the things I can do now. I can still contribute in some way to people. And some of my efforts over the years have paid benefits for people that have come behind me.